Hello, my name is Aaron Channel, and I will be presenting my PowerPoint portion of this project. Introduction. For this PowerPoint presentation, I will be discussing elements of Asian culture. As well, this PowerPoint will also feature the religion known as Buddhism. Another focus of this presentation will be in regards to karma, and will wrap up highlighting the female culture and as well as Generation Z. Asian culture, art. Asian art can be traced back to the 5th century BC, when people of the Hindu or Buddhist faith would decorate the walls of their temples with elaborate carvings and statues. Today, Asian art can be primarily seen in many different places, from buildings to entertainment such as anime or manga. However, unlike what most people would think about today as Asian art, not all art features people with large eyes, little mouths, and multicolored hair, unlike most stereotypical art assumptions would lead one to believe. Instead, the art provided by individuals is unique and varying in styles, just like anywhere else. Asian culture, music. The history of music in Asian culture was known to be less about providing harmony and enjoyable sounds, and more about storytelling. On many islands in Asia, the people living there would provide songs and dancing to regale others of myths or heroic tales. An example of this can be seen in 1954 film Gojira, the film better known in the United States as the 1956 film Godzilla, featured a scene towards the beginning of the film when the main characters view a legend being told in the form of song and dance of a great monster. Asian culture lifestyle. Asia consists of 48 different countries and thus has a plethora of vastly different cultures. Asian people are often very hospitable and family-driven. This is a positive stereotype that is often overlooked by people who mock it and don't understand it. These stereotypes show that more often than not, Asian culture is one of understanding and kindness, even to people who are not Asian. And as you can see here, highlighted are all of the countries that make up Asia. The next topic will be on Buddhism, subcategory of karma. Early Buddhist writings suggest that not all that we experience is a result of past action. It may be due to natural events of one sort or another. Thusly, all the good and bad things that happen to us are the results of past actions. This mindset is different from the common stereotype that leads us to believe that good things happen to good people and vice versa with bad things and bad people. Buddhism, the Four Noble Truths. The Four Noble Truths of Buddhism are the truth of the cause of suffering, the truth of the end of suffering, and the truth the path that leads to the end of suffering. I know, kind of a mouthful, right? These ideas lead the followers of Buddhism to believe the pragmatic perspective of the world and attempts to rectify it. These are hardly ever talked about when discussing the topic of Buddhism, and thusly is overlooked by many in favor of the next topic. Reincarnation. Reincarnation is the belief in the Buddhist culture that the actions of a person lead to new existence after death, in an endless cycle called samsara. Sorry if I butchered that, but I'm trying here. Most people bring up a stereotype of reincarnation as being born as something better because you were good, or something worse if you were bad. And as you can see, I provided a little bit of art that I found, apparently highlighting reincarnation. The next topic is female culture. Female culture has been on the uprise ever since the diverse social movement in the 1960s and the 1970s. Since then, females have proven that they can do anything that their male counterparts can do, thus changing the world forever. Female culture. Rights. The rights of women in the United States have been established in society since 1960 AD, at the start of the women's rights movement. This movement had sought equal rights and opportunities and greater personal freedom for women. Unlike other countries, women have the same rights as men in the United States, and thus combat the negative stereotype that a woman's place is in the kitchen. Female culture under agency. Women's agency is most commonly understood to mean a woman's intrinsic agency, or the belief in herself and awareness of her rights as a human being. The thing that sets a female on the course of moving past outdated stereotypes of being helpless is the fact that they know their own worth as human beings and thus don't settle for anything below fair treatment. The next topic I would like to bring up is Generation Z, with a subcategory in diversity. Generation Z is the United States' most racially and ethnically diverse generation currently. As well, in that regard, there is much more Hispanic and Asian presence among the United States children today. Common stereotypes about Generation Z are that they are lazy and unimaginative. However, most Gen Z are taking college-level classes and preparing to join the workforce. Generation Z, first digital natives. Generation Z is the first ever generation to be born and raised with the use of modern technologies, such as iPhones or computers. For a long while, millennials were known to be more tech-savvy. Generation Z, however, is even more so, being brought up with the items that millennials had to learn about, such as, you know, iPhones and computers and such. Generation Z is politically progressive. Generation Z seems to be the most politically progressive generation to date. This is mainly due to the fact that has been reported to be progressive and pro-government. And that is the end of the slideshow. I hope you all have enjoyed it, and I look forward to seeing yours. Thank you.